Hey guys, I'm Dr. Aaron Horschig, and in today's video, I'm gonna show you a hip mobility routine that only takes 5 minutes. All you need is a band. Get up and get down, get up and get down. Hey guys, thanks so much for stopping by the YouTube channel. Here's what we're gonna do. Get the band around your hip as high as you can. Now, the idea behind using a band is it's going to allow us to really get at the hip joint. There's a capsule that surrounds the hip joint that's nice and thick. So by using a band, this is a Rogue Monster band, it's going to allow us to really get at the joint and make as much mobility change as possible. So we're gonna start off in a lunge position. This is a 3-stage approach. The first one you're going to do is you're going to relax as much as possible. You're going to drop your knee in to hip internal rotation. Now, in this position, you're going to then lean forward. If this brings out a pinch sensation in the front side of the hip, like an impingement, you just need to get a little bit more tension on the band. Then try it again. Should not have any pain at all in the front of the hip, maybe a light gapping sensation in the side of the hip. So it's in, drop down, hold for a couple seconds, take a deep breath out, then drop the hand to the ground, push out to the side, squeeze your butt muscles for a couple seconds, and back. Now, during this routine, I want you to do 5 of those. So push in, relax, hand down to the ground, out to the side, squeeze, and relax. 5 of those. Then you're gonna go to the step 2, which is gonna be sort of a blend of the world's greatest stretch. So what we're gonna do is actually get into a full lunge position. Now in this position, I'm going to pick up my back leg. So I'm going to extend my right hip, even though that's not the banded one, and we're gonna work on priming hip extension. So here I'm squeezing my back hip, I'm maybe bringing a light stretch sensation to the hip flexors. And right here, I'm just sort of searching around with my front hip, sort of in and out. I can go back in and do this again. This is something that I picked up from Kelly Starrett, formerly the Mobility Wad, now the Ready State, one of the greatest hip openers ever before you squat and deadlift. So now that you're done with that one, you're gonna do that for about a minute or so, freestyle, and try to hang out in spots where you feel a lot of stiffness. A very helpful drill is contract, relax in that opening position. So once you're down here, pry that hip open, squeeze your glutes as hard as you can, and squeeze your right glute as hard, and then relax. And then come open and squeeze, 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 and then relax. Next, we're going to drop down into the pigeon pose. So from right here, you're gonna take your foot, go as far across as possible. Now for some of you guys, you'll be able to get your foot all the way up here. For others, it may just be a little bit. Find how far you can go, and from there, you're just gonna go back and forth like this. You can come straight up and down, and you can drive that femur out the backside. Again, you're sort of freestyling and sort of finding where is your hip the tightest. After a couple seconds, you can try to bring your foot into a little bit more of that pigeon pose, sit back, relax, and then let's also go into some internal rotation. So from here, I'm now going to bring my foot out to the side, drop back, in and out. Again, you can try to drive that femur straight down, imagining a stretch on the back side of your hip, in and out. And then again, see if you can prop your foot a little bit further out to the side again, a little bit more hip internal rotation. So from there, in and out, and back. So from right there, I've done hip extension on my right side, and I've primed sufficiently hip external rotation and internal rotation in a variety of positions, both being in the lunge and also in that pigeon, or what we would call then the quadruped position. So with done being on that side, we would then go and do the entire other side. So something like this, you can easily do this before squat day, before your deadlift day, anytime you're gonna be training lower body, you've been sitting around all day, nice and tight. We wanna be able to get the body functioning as well as possible. And that requires just a good mobility warm-up. The last thing we wanna do is just spend 30 minutes warming up prior to working out. You wanna be efficient and effective with your warm-up so that you can get into the best possible positions with your training. We don't wanna waste time. So something like this, a couple minutes, and you're ready to go. From here, again, we're gonna drop down into the pigeon pose, feeling a good stretch, hanging out, and then into the internal rotation. There we go.
As you can see, I get a little bit more internal rotation on this right side versus my left side. And then feel pretty good. All right, let's jump up. Then test and retest. See, how's your body feel afterwards? Can you squat down? Maybe feel like you can sink into a little bit better position. That's how you know the mobility work that you did was right for your body. So there you go. That is a 5-minute hip mobility routine. You just need a band. It's gonna be about that thick to allow yourself to really work on the hip and all the associated musculature around the area. Get your hip moving well and get ready for some good squats or deadlifts. So hope you guys liked today's video. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. And until next time, guys, happy squatting.
They say that energy flows where attention goes, so I pay no mind. Why waste my time with all these negative cats scratching? So caught up in their egos, these people have lost.